Hi you guys, welcome back to my channel, Beauty is Her Name. You already know who it is on the camera, Beauty. I'm back at you guys with another makeup tutorial today. This is going to be an Easter makeup tutorial, and this is a get ready with me. So I am going to be showing you guys what I'm wearing. You guys, please don't mind my eyes throughout this video. I almost canceled this video because the eyeshadow was giving me a really hard time as far as like going under my eyes, as you can see, because I have really bad problems with my eyes, and it has to do with my health, and I can't help it. And sometimes they will like overwater, and I don't know what's up with them today. Like, my eyes have been bothering me for the last couple of days, so I should have expected this, but I didn't think it was going to be like this. So right now I'm in the process of just waiting until my eyes stop this watering stuff that's going on, and then I'm going to go back in and touch up my blue eyeshadow. So please do not mind me, you guys. If you guys see throughout the video that I'm missing some shadows or whatever, don't joke on me. It's something that I cannot help, and I'll get more into that later. I want to go ahead and get right into this tutorial. Like I said, I was 2 seconds away from completely shutting down this entire tutorial. I had to take all of my makeup off my face because when I got to the part where I think it was after I put the blue eyeshadow on and everything, my eyes just started watering, like completely insane watering. And I actually wanted to wear this out today, but I may not wear the blue because my eyes are just watering really bad. As you guys can see, they're getting worse as I'm talking. So I may not wear the blue. I might just wipe that off and keep it natural. But I did want to wear this blue eyeshadow with this outfit that I have on, because I figured, being that I have on black and white, the blue would have brought it out. I'm so disappointed that, you know, it did not turn out well. But towards the end of the video, you guys are going to see the finished look. You're going to see how the blue came out. You're going to see all of that. And it's going to be neat and everything else. I did curl my hair a little bit in this video, so you guys can see that. I hope you guys enjoy this video. Don't forget to thumbs up this video, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please don't forget to subscribe before you go. I really appreciate all the love and support, and thanks so much for watching this video once again. And I'm about to go and clean my eyes off, and you guys can go ahead and enjoy this tutorial. So let's just get right into it.
So I will be doing a voiceover today, you guys. As you guys can see, I'm working on my brows first. I know you guys are like, what in the hell is on your face? I actually put my Milk of Magnesia on today on my face for a primer. I was using the NYX Honey Do Me Up primer, which was working well and everything, but I just wanted to use the Milk of Magnesia. I feel like it gives me a better hold on my makeup, especially since I was going to be out in the heat today. All I did was just fill in my eyebrows, you guys, and, you know, making them out to look nice and natural. And, you know, I'm into like the thick look, so lately I've been doing the thick brow. Well, not thick, but like, you know how it's, they're dark, they're very dark, and normally I don't do them like that, but I feel like you get a better brow that way. And I'm trying something new with the concealing my brows. On the top, I'm putting a darker concealer, and underneath I put a lighter concealer. That way I won't have that halo effect on top of my brow, just under my brow, which it will only show a little bit, which is okay. And now I'm just gonna touch everything up. And now I'm going back in my Correcting Conceal palette by Cardi Professionals. I'm going to list everything that I'm using down below. And I'm just going to cover up all my red spots, all my dark spots. I'm going over my nose because it's the reddest sometimes. And then I'm just going to go in with my Beauty Blender. And it is damp, with some rose water. And I'm just going to blend everything in, you guys. You guys, in this tutorial, I did not use foundation. Once again, being that I'm going to be out in the heat, I didn't want to put anything, extra if it was not needed. Sometimes the concealer gives me good coverage along with the setting powder, in which it did. So I skipped the foundation. So, and now I'm just touching up my brows again, you guys. And I just set my face with the anesthesia powder. And now I'm just putting some LA Girl Pro Concealer on my lid. I'm going to put that on my lid and under my eye. And I'm going to just set my lid with my LA Girl Nudes Eye Palette. And it's the lightest color in the eye palette. I'm going to set everything and just blend it in. And now I'm taking that lightest shade in the Nudes Palette, as you guys can see. And I'm putting that down as my transitioning color. And I'm just going to blend everything in very well. And now I'm going back in with a darker nude shade. And I'm going to start putting that in my crease. And that's going to help define my crease, as you guys can see. And on my lid, I'm getting this gold sparkly color I just did halfway. And I went back in with that second nude color we used in our crease, and I'm just going to put that on my outer corners and drag that inwards. Now my liner worked out really well, you guys. I'm using my NYX liner. Okay, as you guys can see, it's liquid. It worked out really well for me in this tutorial. I actually did it the way that I learned here recently, which was to draw your simple line first and then go ahead and draw your line for your wing. You guys are going to see coming up how I did that. Okay, and everything turned out pretty well, both eyes. And now I'm going in with my NYC mascara, and I'm going to coat my lashes with that. And now I'm going to go ahead and start to highlight my face, under my eyes, my cupid's bow, my chin area, and also my forehead and down the bridge of my nose. And then, you guys, I'm going to blend everything out using my beauty blender, which I did apply more rose water by this time to go ahead and blend everything out. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I really appreciate the support. I know it was kind of like all over the place in the beginning, but I wanted to show you guys truly what happened in this video. And plus, I was excited to get on the camera and talk anyway. So I appreciate you guys watching this video, mess ups and all. Don't forget to thumbs up this video if you guys would like to see more videos like this one, as far as get ready with me. I really enjoyed doing this video for you guys. So all I'm doing now here, I'm using my anesthesia powder only. And I'm just using that to set my face, you guys. And I do not keep the powder on long. Maybe about 1 to 2 minutes, and then I went ahead and brush everything off. My mama told me boy make good decision. Right now I gotta keep a ton of vision. They sending all my homies on a mission. And now going into my anesthesia contour palette, I'm going to go ahead with that second darkest color, and I'm just going to carve out my cheeks, you guys. I'm going to go around my forehead, right into my temples. You don't want to bring it down too far. And then I'm just going to blend everything out. And now I'm putting down my LA Girl Pro Concealer right underneath my cheek contour. And I'm just going to blend everything in using my beauty blender. And then I'm going to go ahead and set it, you guys, with my angled sponge. Angled beauty blender, I guess. And this is going to set everything. We're going to keep this on for a few minutes. I'm also going to contour my nose using the same color that I used for my cheeks. And I'm using my Kabuki style brush here. And I just wanted to do some extra blending over my nose to blend out the harsh lines. And I also did the same thing on my forehead, around my forehead highlight. And now I'm just brushing all the excess powder off. And I'm going back in with my face angle Kabuki style brush. And I'm just, you know, touching up my face, as you guys can see. Bringing that contour up a little bit higher. And then I'm just blending everything out. And now I'm going to contour my chin area.
They wanna see you in a penitentiary. I need me a little baby who gon' listen.
Now in with my NYX white liner, I'm using my Beauty Bomb brush, which I'm sure is for the eyes, how small it is. And I'm just going to go ahead and line underneath my eye, a thin line. I'm going to use this as a base for our color that we're going to put down. I'm not going to put too much because I don't want it to be too cakey or anything. And I'm taking that electric blue that you guys just seen me point at, and I'm putting that directly on top. And I'm just blending everything out until we get a solid color. You know, you don't want to really see any of that white. You only want to see that color blue. And I'm just blending everything out as I go along. This look was so pretty until I messed up my eyes, till my eyes started bothering me, going crazy. I just went in with another blue, you guys, and just layered that right on top of that electric blue. And now I'm just touching up my highlight, blending it in. I'm going to reset it with my anesthesia powder, and then I'm just going to go back over the blue to kind of touch it up a little bit.
Making all the wrong turns, saying all the wrong words, dodging
it. And now with my NYX finishing spray, I'm gonna set my face. And with my e.l.f. highlighter, I'm gonna go ahead and highlight my face, you guys. My forehead, on my cheeks, and on your cheeks, when you highlight your cheeks. If you're using a fan brush, it makes it easier. You're just gonna point the fan brush downwards, like brush it downwards into your contour. That way everything will blend. And now I'm gonna go down the bridge of my nose, you guys. And I'm also gonna go on my Cupid's bow and my chin. And then I'm gonna just blend everything out. And now in my inner corners with some of that moonlight pearl, I thought that would bring out the look a little bit more. As you guys can see right in this take, this clip here, my eye, well, it would be you guys' left, my right eye started messing up on the inner corner. By this time of the video, I had completely washed my makeup off my face besides my eyebrows and started completely over. I don't know if you guys can tell or not, but I liked it the second time around. It looks very pretty. And now I'm just getting into the hair, you guys. I'm using my wand curler. I can't remember how much this curler costed me, maybe about $20 to $30. And I'm just, you know, wand curling my hair. I wanted to have some spiral curls for this look today, and I just felt like curling my hair today, so I was like, what the hell, why not? And if you guys want to see a separate tutorial on how to wand curl your hair, please leave that, leave that comment down in the comment section below. That way I know you guys want to see that, and I will record an actual video dedicated to how to wand curl your hair. so you guys know exactly how to do it. I mean, it was hard for me in the beginning. Like, I had a hard time because of the way you have to hold the curler. It took me a while to get used to it. As you guys can see, you have to point it downwards and start with wrapping your hair around from the top of the curler down. And you have to do it that way or else the curl will come out crazy. This is a rush job, you guys, so don't mind the fact that the curls are not perfect. To be honest, I was going for, like, you know, a wavy kind of look. Like, I didn't want it to be super curly because, to be honest, I know that that takes a lot more work and I would have had to really sit down and curl it, you know. And now I'm just moving on to the other side. The back of it, I kind of touched just a little bit. Like I said, this was a quick job. I was actually leaving out to go somewhere, so I was rushing just a little bit. But I think the curls still turned out pretty good for the amount of time that I did have to do it. And now I'm just going to finish up my hair, you guys, and then we're going to get right into my outfit and what I wore in just a few. So just please continue watching. Okay, you guys, let's get into this outfit. So the first thing that I'm putting on is my corset. If you guys would like to know more information about this corset, please let me know down in the comment section below. I could do a separate video. I like to wear this when I'm wearing leggings. It does give you that shapely look. And now I'm just putting on here next my cover up, you guys. My cover up and my leggings I got from doing some volunteering, you guys. And the top that I got that's underneath my cover up is from a local store here in my area, about $3 to $6 or so for this top. I really like how all this went together with the stripes. This is my first time putting on everything, so I didn't know how it was gonna look. Now I'm putting on my bangles, which I believe I got in a set from a local store here in my town. And then now my Jordans. All the jewelry probably was like no more than like $20 for it all or less. My Jordans were like $100 from the mall here in the area. And now I'm just showing you guys the back. Oh, I love this shot right here. I'm not bossy, I'm the boss, bitch. I love it. And I'm just showing off everything all together. I wish I could have got the camera back further enough, but you guys wouldn't be able to see that good, so. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to thumbs up this video if you guys would like to see more Get Ready With Me makeup tutorials. I simply enjoyed this tutorial, you guys, and I hope you guys enjoyed it too. Thanks so much for watching once again. I appreciate all the love and support, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!